What does this serpent plan to do with those young women? Sure, he doesn't intend to marry all of them. No duh, Sherlock. Anyways, Jackie K here, and welcome to another edition of Let's Play Golden Sun: The Lost Ages. The last episode, we hit Izumo and really got into serious business. I mean, really, giant serpents that require maiden sacrifices. Apparently, maidens like young woman. Sacrificing young ladies year after year, bringing doom and destruction to the village if they don't? That's pretty dang serious stuff. Fortunately, there's a legend of a legendary hero who will come on the full moon and save the day. And I don't know if we're quite legendary, well, except Jenna. Jenna's everything legendary. So since Jenna is legendary, and since Felix Party is with Jenna, we're gonna save the town. Now, I did a little class arrangement because, no spoilers, but Whirlwind is gonna be playing a significant role in this dungeon. Looks like this is gonna be placed here. Too bad we don't really have anything to place. And actually, I'm going the wrong way. We want to actually climb up the mountain before going inside the mountain. Crazy, I know. But for the sake of the village, we must. Jenna, the legendary hero, shall save the day and bring victory and peace to all who live in the village. First Izumo, then the world! Justice shall be prevailed. Yes, I am going there. And no, I was not planning, but now that it's in my head, it's gonna stay that way. Speaking of the legendary hero, Jenna, I did a little bit of class arrangement because I was doing preparing by looking ahead into the dungeon, and we're gonna need Whirlwind. And instead of dealing with having to set all my digits and reset them and all that, I've decided just to have Shibuya in our default class, so we can use Whirlwind whenever we please. Now, this leaves a problem. Who's gonna heal? Well, Felix is now in his default class, so if we need some cures, we can take care of that. Jenna is in a class which I know I went into in the last Golden Sun game, but I'm not sure if I did here. Is it the Brute class? It has a pretty good assortment of fire and earth synergies, so Jenna's gonna be a force to reckon with in battle, but if we need an Aurora, I can just set the one digit. So much easier than setting all of Shibuya's digits. And by set, I mean standby. Of course. They're the same thing, of course. And we're gonna have to go around either way. So might as well just move this guy over there now. Backtracking, yay! Circling. Oh, well, you know, we somehow teleported in the middle of the fight. I didn't even know this. Hopping along, though. And now we can get onto the other side of the tree. Yeah, make progression, yay! Don't worry, Jenna, your legendary hero destiny shall be fulfilled. And you see that vine that's right above our heads? Well, keep note of it. These sort of vines will come into play a bit later on in the dungeon, and it will explain why I arranged my class the way I did. Jenna's gonna make some stuff blow! That battle took long enough. I guess that dead end was not complete. It was completely worthless. Ugh. No, I don't get why I don't fill these seeds and crystal powers. I never use battle items in battles. Well, I might use them occasionally to just to get rid of them or use them up, but I usually don't. That's the more accurate term. And I like to see where I'm going. The key is going up. so I definitely don't want to go down. I mean, that's just common sense. But I am getting worried I'm missing an item along the way. I'm not sure if I said this before. Actually, I'm pretty sure I have, but... yeah, forgive me if I'm a little rusty around this part of the... oh! See this vine? That is why we want Whirlwind available. I was attempting to do this with a different class. I think I pointed this out in the last Golden Sun game, but... you remember the ninja class? That has Gale, which is pretty much the same thing as Whirlwind. I was trying to do that, because it would be more fun to play with ninjas instead of... Shibuya's basic class. Unfortunately, we do not have enough Degens yet to actually do that. There we go, Felix. Stop moaning around the vine. I wasn't quite sure what you're doing to that vine, so that's the best adjective I could come up with to describe your action. But now we can push this down and make progression! Hurrah! Thank you, Mr. Random Tiki Whirlwind Pull. I don't know what you're doing way out here, but I'm glad you were there to show the vine viewers at home why we want to use Whirlwind on the vines. Speaking of Whirlwind on vines, there's one right there, but I'm just gonna climb down real quick to see if I'm missing out on any items. Kinda doesn't look like it, but I can't be too careful. Well, there is another way to climb up at the very least. It'll be interesting to see where this goes to. It might actually be the right way. Or it could be a detour. Or it could be the completely wrong way. Or it could be a detour. Now, yeah, it took me a little bit to figure that out, but you actually have to press A when the vine is flung to you after a wind actually swing. A little silly, I know. Otherwise, Felix just yanks away at the vine. Which doesn't make any sense to me. But I'm not gonna play with the game design. It's a very minor game design problem. Game design problem, yes. Is it gonna break the game? Is it gonna make it... hello there, Mr. Jerksetti! I hate your face, and it's blocking the way! I get the feeling we'll have to watch out for those guys in the future. If only there was a way to actually tell where they are. Or were. I'm gonna assume there's a Mr. Jerksetti somewhere below my feet, so I'm gonna ignore it. Something tells me I should ignore the big areas and just focus on the narrow ones. Okay, I made at least that far, so we don't have to worry about... by the power of the goodwill, EXPLOSION! In the face! And Jenna is now a level 26 brute! An energy hero! Jenna, the brute full legendary hero! Who will save this village from the crisis of the evil giant serpent? It's ironic because the serpent likes young maidens, but Jenna's gonna give that serpent a knuckle sandwich right in the face! Ain't that right, Jenna? Am I talking to the game again? Am I talking to characters within the video game again? Oy. Jenna! Kick! I wonder how many people in those village of Izmu actually were expecting a legendary female hero to come and save their butts. I bet none of them were expecting that, but that's gonna be exactly what happens. Although, even the greatest of heroes need some support from their friends. Which is why we got Felix, Shibuya, and Pierce. Friends are important, but in the end, it's the hero that makes the stories, the tales, the legends, and everything that shines. Now, can we cross this ledge. I mean, it shouldn't be this difficult. There we go. Onwards. Legendary hero awaits, but first, legendary hero must have legendary treasures. So all that work of pushing the log was pointless because I have to come back here and push the log up anyways. Don't you love depth perception? I think that will work. It should work. And I can't believe I wasted my time with that. Jenna, the legendary hero, does not have time for shenanigans. She only deserves the glory and action and fun. Appleday does keep the doctor away. Unfortunately, it does not keep the monsters away. It's a little sad that Piers actually has less attack than Jenna. Granted, Jenna is the legendary hero. Oh yeah, her class. The Brute class is very good for attack. And I forget what else. I was just looking at it in my magazine. But that would explain why Jenna's attack is so low. Let's put it back in default so we can get a better idea of who to give the apple to. Wow, Jenna is still more awesomely awesome. I think Piers really needs the attack moves. But who could expect less from the legendary hero? Am I right? I don't even know how I'm gonna keep track of the Jenna counter for this one. Jenna was so awesome, she blew up the fourth wall. I mean, this whole episode has just become one big Jenna fanboyism. How am I ever gonna divide it up? Well, we'll figure that out in editing. I'm just on such a roll with Jenna and her being a legendary hero. I can't think of anything else to talk about. But I gotta try. A good joke is only good for so. Kaboom! Dragon Rock! Yeah. I guess that'll spice things up a little. I keep thinking about my classes, seeing what else I can doing battles. In case you can tell from the snippets of shadows? Sure, shadow battles that I've shown. Out of those. Zombies, that's what it was. There's zombies again. Yeah. Just when you thought you seen the last of media's most annoying feature. Zombies make another return. I'm sensing something. Something from another dimension? Well, pretty much. The dancing is so remotely relaxable. No, come back! I miss your dancing! You know, a legendary hero, such as Jenna, deserves only the best. And you, my good sir, have the honors of being the best. And it even went straight to Jenna. So this dancing idol, what could we possibly do with it? I got an idea, but I think we'll save that for the next episode. First of all, since we're on the top, we're gonna retreat back to the bottom. And next time on Let's Play Golden Sun, The Lost Ages, we shall go back into the inside of the rock and collect our reward for our efforts. I don't know why I'm thinking of collecting, we're probably just gonna get a little more progression out of it. But until then, see y'all later.